9-6 in kills. Those fights have gone better. The hook's not going to land. The stun certainly will. Will they knock down Vulcan? Not just yet. Finds a backline stun. Damage on Santorin. Gets taken down. And Blabber's still on the chase. Gets pushed back. Oh, barely gets back on the ultimate. Here comes Event Horizon. Here comes re-engage. Huge damage from PoE, but it's not going to be enough. Turtle is going to get punched to death. And Sven is free firing as well. FlyQuest can try to find the kill onto Blabber. Solo gets a bit close. It is going to be a big deal. He's obviously off to the races now, item-wise. I will point out that Power Beevil does have some more defensive tools. Nice flash follow, but Sven is already fairly safe back there. Ignar's flash really accomplishes nothing.
Yeah.
Sad to say. And now Wild Turtle slowed, still flashless. Not a chance to get away. Burns the heal, but he's still not going to live through it. And Ignar, when is Flay back up? Can they pull him in? There's the Oslo ult. There's a ton of damage. And we're just taking double kill for double kill for double kill. Sven on the board for two.
Ignar looks a little tilted. It looked nice as a flash follow, but that play was never going to work, and it turns to disaster. Now they're going for more. Blabber's here for the counter gank.
2v1 top side, make it 2v2 already. Blabber knocks back Santor. The turret shuts the health bar, and like I said, double kill into double kill into double kill. Cloud9 take turns batting the stats. Cloud9 stay grouped up. They get rid of most of the wards. There is the darkness. There is now FlyQuest not knowing what's going on this side of the map. There's the hook into the front line. There's the block. They play back solo. And here comes the engage yet again. Stopwatch gets burned on a Blabber. Nitsky's already in the back line. Fights Santorin, who jumps away and stays alive. The Blabber finds out the first kill. The second one goes over to his top laner. And that wind ball was perfect. It blocks everything from PoE. A double kill for the jungler. Double kill for the top laner. There's the kills coming through fast and furious. The Bud Light Ace for Cloud9. They will not go for the Dragon. They will go for the Nexus. A 30-minute win is almost slow for their taste, but it was dominant the whole way through. Cloud9 going to have a 2-0 lead in the finals on their way to be the best team to ever defeat North America. This is a slaughter as the Nexus falls.
Nitsky proves he is not a KDA player. Guarding against a loss,
okay,
and here goes FlyQuest.
The attempt towards Blabber. Ult goes over the top and dives right back out, and Santorin cannot escape the fire and fury of the Cloud9 team fight. That's going to be a rough one for FlyQuest. Not unlocks the push. FlyQuest not going to be able to fight 4v5, especially with Ignar's ulti down, but they're going to try with Scylla getting a knockup, but already stopped and hooked back in and played back in and killed and sent back to the fountain. Cloud9 are now 5v3 on the map. And the power play continues as they knock down the inhibitor turret. The inhibitor gonna drop as well. Still 35 seconds left on this, as well as the wait till this comes up. Power of Evil's gotta be respectful. Hook almost predicted correctly, and this might be the Cloud9 reset. They're gonna kite backwards. They find the root, and the flash over for the double chase down. Blabber gets himself a double, and it's 5 versus 2. They're ready to keep going. It's a 3-for-1 team fight, and it might be a fourth. Licorice is still trying to find a bit more into Ignar. He's gonna stab him in the back. And a 4-for-1 team fight. They don't need the Baron. They need to push down the base. They just needed one team fight, and they got it. Solo is the only thing standing in the way of Cloud9 lifting the trophy, and it's not going to be enough.
He's trying to stall as much as possible.
He's got respawns in 10 seconds. He's a tanky man. Redemption helps build the time, though, and that is Nitsky on a rampage. Santorin's back alive. The Nexus turrets are going to fall. Santorin goes for minions, then back to the engage. The bot lane's alive in 5 seconds, but they will not stop it. Cloud9 waited 6 years, and they will hoist the trophy again. For all 5 players, the first time in their careers, the Nexus falls. Licorice deals the killing blow, and Cloud9 win the 2020 LCS Spring Split.